In today's episode, we are going to watch Matt Steffanina's Black Beatles choreography dance video. Black Beetle cream seats in the Regal rockin' John Lennon. What's good, world? It's your boy, the Earthling Gangsta. Welcome to my channel. Y'all know the drill. This channel is for motivation, strategy, and professional development for any artist looking to strategically increase their performance and or income. So if you're an artist looking to get those kind of results, subscribe to my channel. Like this video. Like these videos. Leave comments. Let's engage. Okay, and also you're gonna want to make it to the end of this video, because at the end of the video I'm gonna be giving away 3 tips on how you can get the kind of traction to your videos like Matt Steffanina is getting traction to his videos. This dude gets millions of views. So let's get straight to this video. I'm super hyped. That girl is a real cloud DJ. One sec, gotta find it. Okay. Here we go. Oh, I gotta press play. Hey. You gotta show everybody dancing before, you know, the big dance comes out, you know what I mean? Hey. Hey. Okay. So that dude right there in the brown shirt is Matt Steffanina. Super dope dude. Black Beatles, here we go. Hey. Hey. That was tight. Hey. I like those moments. Yeah, I like those moments. Hey. Hey, the dude dancing beside Matt's dope. Hey, okay, okay, all right. Hey, all right, so we're gonna watch a couple of these groups. We're gonna see how everybody adds their own little flavor to it. See that tutorial stuff right there? Keep that in mind. Hey. Now, Josh is dope, man. I've seen this dude dance live at Choreographer's Cup in LA. Dude was real dope. His choreography is sick. Hey. 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 I think he's actually featured in the Hoverboards video that they did to that Justin Bieber song. Hey. Hey. Yeah, they're killing it. Those two dudes in the back are gay. Oh, the dub. It was the dub. Hey. Get it, my Asian friend. Okay. You see the Asian girl in a lot of his videos. I haven't seen this girl before. That at least I don't recognize her, but she's killing it too. Hey. That was tight. Hey, 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 hey. I like her shirt. It says mind over matter. That's what we talk about all the time. That's what this channel's about. Okay, we had to watch this one. Check it. Still killing it. 9 months pregnant. Like, what? Like, what? That's it. No excuses. No excuses whatsoever. You gotta go out there and do it. Hey. Yup. She's slaying it, absolutely slaying. 9 months pregnant. That baby's about to pop out any moment. What if it came out in the middle of the dance? Dude, that's nasty. Hey, that's tight. Actually, one of my ballet teachers was kind of similar. She was dancing real hard all the way into the week before she had her baby. It was crazy, man. And she's had like 2 kids, and she She doesn't look like she's had a kid at all. Hey, so we're just going to stop here. It's 3 minutes, almost 4 minutes into the video. So, dope video. I love that. I love what I saw. Everybody absolutely killed it. Okay, like I said, I promise. We're going to give 3 tips on how Matt Steffanina gets so much traction, how Matt Steffanina, as an artist, was able to turn his craft into a business to where I know he makes pretty good money, right? at least good money, especially for a craft that people say you're bound to be broken. So 3 reasons why he gets these kind of results. Okay, the first one, all right, and this is real businessy, okay? Matt Steffanina uses the freemium business model. Okay, so here's what the freemium business model is. Now, you're going to find a lot of entrepreneurs reference this kind of stuff if you do a lot of entrepreneurship stuff and understand the business aspect of things. And artists are starting to do this too, right? The freemium model is where you give away a lot of free information, okay? Or you give away some free services, right? And then people will have the option to upgrade to a premium service where you charge a higher price offer. What this does is this lets people test your product and service, right? They get Matt, for example, with his videos. One, he posts videos. That's a part of his freemium model. And two, he does free tutorials that anybody can go to. That's dope. So you get to, one, see his stuff. Two, get to see how he teaches a little bit for free. And if you like it, you get to buy into his service and hire him to come out and teach at a workshop or at a class, or maybe hire him to do some choreography or something. Number two, search engine optimization, specifically YouTube search engine optimization, okay? So what Matt does is, if you notice, Matt dances to a lot of songs that people are already searching for. This is fantastic for choreographers who don't have a big name yet, or artists who don't have a big name, anybody. Post stuff, or YouTubers who don't have a big name, post stuff that people are already searching for, okay? Yeah. If you go through my analytics, right, a lot of my views aren't from people typing in the Earthling Gangster or Stephen Clark, right? It's from people typing in Eric Thomas book review, okay? People typing in how to become a better artist, right? Matt Steffanina, he just danced to Black Beatles. That's a really, really popular song. A lot of his songs, scroll through, they're going to be on iTunes top 100 list. That's what a lot of his songs are. And there's nothing wrong with this model. It's great. So people are already searching for this kind of dance, the juju on that beat dance. And then what dance pops up, that's what they click on. Some people hate on this kind of strategy, and that's fine. You can hate if you want to. But I don't think it should be your only motivation as an artist. Like, I'm just going to dance to popular songs. Like, no, like, do unpopular songs. Do your own thing. Experiment. But whenever it comes to turning your art into a business and getting that kind of marketing traction, then this is a great way to do that. So search engine optimization. Specifically YouTube, there's Google search. There's a bunch of other stuff. But the basics. Number three. Okay, here's the thing. Number three reason why Matt Steffanina gets so much traction is because he's actually a good dancer and a good choreographer, okay? We talk a lot about, you don't have to be the best choreographer. You don't have to be the best artist in the world, right? You don't have to be the best dancer, best painter, best actor, but you have to be willing to work hard. However, you can't be a completely crappy artist, okay? Like no talent whatsoever. Like, you should be in something else. You should be playing basketball, be doing something else, right? But you're rapping or singing, or I can't hold a tune, but you're singing or something. You have to be at least pretty good. You're going to find that all these people are these successful artists who maintain their success, okay? You can get really successful for a little while not being really good, but eventually you got to maintain it, and people are just going to not like your stuff. So Matt Steffanina is actually a pretty solid, really good choreographer and dancer. He's not a trash, okay? So if you're looking to get that kind of traction with whatever you're trying to get some traction in, you got to at least be really good at it. So those are 3 tips. Now, those aren't the only ways Matt Steffanina has gained traction. I'm sure he does other stuff, but those are 3 tips that I guarantee you, if you can get those 3 things down, then you can start getting more traction to your channel. Y'all know who it is. It's your boy, the Earthling Gangster. I'm not your life coach. I'm not your guru. I'm not Matt Steffanina. I just am. Don't waste another second. Subscribe to a better future filled with creativity, fulfillment, and impact. Subscribe to this channel, leave comments, engage with me, and check out the rest of my videos instantly with a click of a button. Y'all know the drill. Master your movement, make your mark, and maximize your message.